is free with new and interesting features, poems, a recitation, Bible verses, games, and story time with Auntie Lucy. Or 0886-529-605. Better still, 0777-533-85.
This is Angel Marco, baby. The angel refused to come to Liberia. You know, the main reason why I come to Liberia because God spoke to me in my dream. God said, oh, Angel Marco, you have to go to Liberia. I said, oh, but there's no leg, no leg there. He said, oh, no, but we have leg. And I said, what kind of leg? He said, light TV. I said, oh, I thought I allowed all light. Because 200 stars with a ZL. Now it's like light TV. Since I came to LeBron, I wanted to go back. I nearly changed my mind. I swear to God, I wanted to go back. But since I started watching light TV, hey, God, light TV can show fun program. Hey, God, you see light TV, only on light TV, me can see quality sport. Oh, God, like I go watch light TV, I see the guy that goes to school, Puska go. I go put a lot of station on, I go to school, I go to school, or Hamburg go. That two different things came up. Light TV been a real one, real Puska go. Man, see me enjoying it like the quality for God. Hey, God, see light TV, they can show all the fun music on there. But hey, God, I see them in my living room watching my TV, my phone, they're dancing for myself. I swear to God, all the best movie, like great movie that you can think about, our culture, only light TV, the drama, comedy drama. You want to see in your mouth, I think funny, tune into light TV, you will see me clear, color, color, visa, green, bag, out to out. I tell you, you see rusty, so you take by the money, you sit in your living room. Make sure you tune into light TV. Because I'm going to go back here, I'm going to go back because of light TV. Light TV is the best station, they entertain me every day. So wherever you are, whether you're Liberia, you're Sierra Leone, you're Guinea, I'm not in Jamaica saying that England refused to come to Liberia, now I hear that because of light TV. Tune into light TV. Everybody has been accepted for it.
What's up, what's up, LIB? This is your boy Dench. Keep watching Live TV, your home for Liberian music. One love.
Anthony Tatman Stadium, March 7, LFA. With 10 men each from either side. FC Facel already on the pitch, consulting their maker. No one can give them victory except for their maker. So they are doing just that, trying to call on the most powerful one to give them favor as they look to pass. And let's call for a part. He's trooping onto the page, wearing the blue and white jersey. Daniel Woto, Julius Knott, Emmanuel Tappe, Christopher Jackson, Bleedy. They are all coming into this one. As referee Kofado shown two red cards already. We saw it in the first half. After Liska consulting the oracles, the game will be starting here. Just what FC Facel did, resorting to their maker, the divine one, to give them the victory. So who is he going to listen to? Everybody. Liska or Facel, I don't know. In every case, in either case, they will have to work. If you want to win this one, you need to work and work harder. To get the favor you need to work hard. Second and final half, March 7th. It's BYC. Invincible 11 came so strong from behind to beat Jubilee. 2-1. And surely Dekokwe was the man of that match. It's another opportunity for Invincible 11 to come back into this one. Second and final half started. Goalkeeper Giddings. To Elijah Clark, Clark controls, back to Nimlen. Nimlen, Walate, dispossessed. The referee sounds his whistle for high kick against Dominic Jrate. Samanjara on the far side. He raised his own. Fala Sheriff with contest. And Jrate play far back to DDA Sosa. Sosa to Nimlen Abed. Nimlen swing one. And Bleedy clears his line. Dominate. Beautiful chest pass from the striker. A relaxed pass. Foul against Eddie Wudu. FC Facel, one of Liberia representatives in the CAF Cup. Eliminated by Horry of Guinea. After a two-leg play in Guinea. And then Woto Jackson just calling. There was a way in Mali against Horia. Cool header from Emmanuel Tappe. Nimlen Abed. It was a terrific run from Nimlen, but he's been injured in the process. He maneuvered his way, meander his way through the defense of Liska. Unleashed a terrific shot, injuring himself. But he have one corner for Liska. And Aloysius will cross the pitch to take this one. And Abed is crying. Liska is reduced to 9. Best one, but not completely. And Sousa acrobatically take this one. But Songo was to the tax. Songo saved the situation. Quickly by Eddie Wudu to Alosha. Alosha swing one. Jericho beating to it. That's Frank Nangbe. It's a throw-in to Liska to be taken quickly by Fala. But he chose to leave it for Woto Daniel. Woto to Besma. Throws on. That was not the best. And Liska. Wulu. Wulu try to run up Julius. Julius beating a pass intended for Koli, but he said to Kujer once again, he plays the 1-2 with Bleedy, and Bleedy touch line as the rain keep toppling down here. At the go to Liska, 1.5, and Abel Nimle will enter the fray now. Facel is going back to their full strength. Throw in to Aloysius. Throw in to Facel, taking quickly. Elijah Clark heads it back to someone. One Tommy Songo, goalkeeper Tommy Songo, the man doing his BSc degree at the Polytechnic, Stella Marie Polytechnic. Throwing at the moment to Liska, taking quickly. And Woto take this one. Julius Brooks back to Julius. Julius to Woto. Woto to Julius. They are counting their passes. A long one. Intended for Bleedy. But Aloysius will heads it to his goalkeeper. And he does that cleverly. Back to Aloysius. The game is quiet. Yet to live up as it was in the first half. Everybody seems to be cautious. Except for the telegraphic run from Abed Nimle. Everything seems to be quiet. Cannavaro have restored calm in his defense ever since his entry. Talking about Emmanuel Tappe, the man wearing number 6 for Liska. At the moment, Bleedy will get by him, Marco Eddie Wudu. He does that cleverly, brought down, referee sounds his whistle. Five against Eddie Wudu, the man who got the goal for FC Facel, who opened up the proceeding here. FC Facel, that goal scored by Emmanuel Wudu will be their 18th goal of the season. 7 games, 18 goals scored so far, FC Facel. They have a very good scoring record as compared to Liska, scoring just their 11th goal. A long one for Jackson. Jackson with race. He can't get to it, but Gini will. And also, James Walate. Nimle slash it for Koli. Koli controls. He uses strength. He can't get by. Cannavaro looks on. A pass for Nimle. He swings it, but Emmanuel Tappe to the tax. Tappe saved this one yet again.
Yeah.
Jackson. And to, it's not a good thing for Liska. And he seems to be okay. Any moment, he will resume. He will return. But they are down. 9-10. 9 men Liska against 10 men for self. Woto will have to come all the way back now. Woto, he racing, beating. Julius now beating to his. Blitty, swing one. And Christopher Sango. Tommy Sango. Slowly becoming the man of the match. And this is dangerous. This is Christopher Sango. Christopher Sango. It's goal number two for Christopher Jackson. For Christopher Jackson. Against the round of play. What a spectacular goal. For the spectacular and elite striker. He has justified his purchase, Christopher Jackson. He's going to be shown the yellow card. But it doesn't matter at this stage. Because his goal is the goal that will beat this FC Facel side. After missing their penalty, they are going to be punished. Remember, he got 2 goals on his debut. This is his second game. So it's 3 goals out of 2 matches for Christopher Jackson. What a goal. What a striker. It's game on here. Liska 2, FC Facel 1. The yellow card has been shown to Christopher Jackson. But Raji will be in the Hall of Fame. This goal is a signal that Liska will top the zone. Because they are already ahead comfortable. Facel. Deep into the. And Facel. Sam Colley seems to be front over the miss of penalty taken by him. He has been the one getting the goals for Facel. But today he let them down. Coach Julu. Hey! It's a wayward strike from Vasari Sieg. So in Liska 2, Facel 1. And goalkeeper Sango will take all the time. They have taken the lead. Shown the first record. Consider the first goal. It's from the young striker Christopher Jackson. Blitty. Try to connect Vasali. He cuts where? He struck it. What a strike from Vasali Sieg. Goalkeeper Sango was beaten. The ball hit the woodworks. It came back. And Emmanuel Tapé was there. Emmanuel Tapé was right on the. Another opportunity to equalize was scrambled. Emmanuel tapping on the ground. And goalkeeper Giddens came up. But he was not good enough because this striker was in an excellent position. He slot 2 to Liska. 1 to Facel. Sango. Sango strike this one. Dominic beating. But Julius now. Brooks. Dispossessed by Wuru. Wuru tried to race on. He crossed this now. Marked by Nah. A pass from Sumanjara. But Tapia with class. And Didier class this line. FC Facet. But he misses the pull by inches. So Liska survived yes again. But FC Facel is paying the consequences for introducing a striker at the expense of a defender. Sousa Didi, Sousa Gary. Beating the gate. This is promising for Bruce. Oh, Bruce. He opted for the pass. Another chance went back in. And Daniel Woto with dispossessed Blitty. Blitty is not satisfied. But that's the end of the game. 2-1, FC Faisal beating again for the second time, 6 points. FC Faisal has contributed 6 points to Liska in their bid to regain their form and go back to Africa to clinch this championship. FC Faisal has donated 6 points, 3 in the first leg, another 3 in the second leg. A goal scored by little striker Christopher Jackson. It has been a wonderful day at the Anthony Tuchman Stadium. Final 3 points, they just couldn't get it for the mistake made would have been better. 5-0, your team just went wrong.
No, it's football. You know, in football, our strategy does not work. It doesn't work for us today. So, but we just have to go back to training and see how best we can move. We can push forward to win our bottom three games.
You came so close for 3 times in the game. You was the first to be in terms of awarded the red card to your opponent. And second, you took the early goal. And then you had a penalty to wrap this one up. But you missed all 3 chances. Now you are going home with nothing. Why did you introduce a striker at the expense of a defender in the latter stage of the second half?
Because we wanted to get a double striker up front to see how best we can convert a goal, but it hasn't worked for us to train in and go back to our drawing board and see how best we can move forward and get our minds concentrated to see how best we can get our three points in the next coming game and see how best we can move for the 9 points in the remaining 3 games. Together, all of the chances came to us, we did not convert, but it is football, so we lost as a team, we win as a team.
Now, what will you make up about the performance of Sam Cuddy, your little striker? He was one man who parried, who missed a lot of chances today for your side. Man, are you disappointed in his performance today?
No, I'm not disappointed because I know he's a prolific striker for me. I believe that he can do better than this. He did it for me in the FPL was in match. He always doing it. He one of my marksmen in my front side. So I believe that because today is just one of the bye time. We could do better. He will work on it.
The 7 points lead today for Aliska is almost game over. What do you think? Can you catch them?
Yes, I just need to get the 9 points from the bottom three games. So then we see how best we see how best our zone will go.
Any other thing you want to express to your many fans that will be listening to you today after your loss?
Yes, I just want to encourage them that they shouldn't be deterred because and for said we don't make them shame. We believe that we can make a very good comeback in the bottom three games. So thanks to all my fans, thanks to all.
Christopher, your goal today will define the championship for Liska. How do you feel?
I feel really happy today. See, my spectator fan who said,
let you get that goal.
Oh, really? It's looking like a dream. I couldn't believe how myself I scored that goal. But just by the grace of God, made me score that goal. I'm very happy. Yeah.
Now you've gone 3 games, 2 games, 3 goals. How do you feel from Ketrick to Liska? 2 games, 3 goals. How do you feel, Chris?
I feel excited. I don't know right now how I'm feeling, but I feel excited. I feel the joy overflowing my heart. Yeah.
Is there any special thing you were told by your coach when you entered the field? Because before the goal, there was an injury to you, and then you came back to the field, hang on to the ball, and then you power your way through. What the coach told you when you went out?
The coach told me to keep on. I tell myself, I believe I can make it. And he told me I can make it. I said, yes, I can make it. And when I went in the field, I made a possible goal.
What is this transition like for you from Ketri to Liska? Is there any different? Are you enjoying football now as it were in Ketri?
Yeah, I enjoy football with Liska. Liska is a good team. They play together, they united, they work the ball. They get 3 chances with neutral Nasir. Liska is a good team. Being with Liska, I'm very happy.
Do you have any final word for your fan out there watching you right now?
To my fan up there, I say, I'm going to keep the faith, the championship for Liska. Let's put him together and pray to God we can get the championship.
Thank you very much.
Thank you too.
Coach, it was a sweet victory from FC Liska. How do you feel, Coach?
I feel more like impressed. Complete tension part. But we being ahead of the game. We
made it in the first red card in the game. And then it was like everything went haywire for you again. What was responsible for that game?
We are hearted with our player counseling them, making them to have a game set mind. We came to the game with 4 back position. So the red card and the goal were nothing to us. When you look at our game, we have won the game that we come from the back to win. So when the goal came, the red card came, the only thing we need to record that we pick up.
And your player seems to be dejected. How was it for you? What did you say to the guys?
It brought more pressure, but I being a head coach, I being very far sighted. I could not talk to them. This things happen in the game of football. The actual team in the game of soccer, you must win, draw, or loss. So when the penalty came, we decided to call them and start talking to them, forget about it. Penalty is not considered a goal until it has been scored. So that we send our goalkeeper to talk to our goalkeeper to keep it on here light.
observe the player movement and go to save the penalty, and that he did to pull ahead. So the saving of the penalty gave up more strength to go out to play, and that we did. As soon as the penalty was saved, we went out with the pressure, they all found another goal.
Coach, you introduced a strange side today. The likes of Fala Sheriff came in and at the expense of Seaman. How did you care? What really went wrong?
I am a family member to Leska. I've been with Leska. We are molding a team. When you look at the reform of Leska, we got a whole lot of young players. We know their strength and their weakness. Fala got his strength and weakness. The reason Fala played today because we have Fala to fit with him. There are other things when we play, you'll see Fala will be on the bench. We are that Fala to be faced with. But so be it. Started jazzing and winning today because Seaman is out. We put Fala into the gap and he failed there. And you saw what he did. He contributed a lot to get the two goals.
You brought in two new players in the presence of Jackson, the man who just got the winning goal for you, and Fred Brooks. Now, I mean, which eye you are using to see them? Because as I see them, they are fit perfectly into your system. How did you acquire their services?
I've been observing long from the time the league started, and I shortlisted that into the president. I tell who work, and I must commend him for his level of relationship with the technical staff. Like I hear from people, Mustafa Al-Raji can draw the team of Leska. It bring about surprise to me that one person from my interaction with Mustafa as a manager. He gave me the go-ahead. I did the scouting of my player. I drew the tune of my player. I drew the blanket of my player, and we come to our game. The way that Mustafa Al-Raji talked to us in our 15, 10 minutes, we come in here. So from the first Saturday that we saw the player, we saw later then we push it to him. Because Mohamed Vani will be leaving Monday or Tuesday for Chaché on a professional contract. So we thought it was to bring Chris to fame to the gap. We have been following Fred game by game. We follow Chris game by game and also broke. So you saw the game, the poetry were only two times. But I've been standing there, I followed them to the practice section because I needed them. So they are showing their weakness and where they play. So
a 7-point lead on the at the top of the table. What's the way forward for Leska?
Consider
the
7-point, 1 point because we don't want to be complacent. We feel that the mission is not over yet. We launched operation, we must win one of the two. If we come next year, we must represent Liberia in Cup Tournament. You don't win the knockout or the championship. So being tapping 7 point, we just consider 1 point. It means the race has just started.
So if you had to give a final word to your fans and to your other players that didn't play today, what would you say to them?
First of all, I want to tell our fans to contain the pressure on us as technicians, because the more the pressure rises us, the more we go on the table to work hard. We don't want to be complacent. They cannot cheer us. They cannot relax. We feel that everything is okay. Then they cannot the pressure rise us. We put on our feet to continue working to make sure to bring the result to them that they always cheer Leska to victory. And we want to ensure our players who did not play, let them keep focused. The team is for everyone. All you saw that even the players did not play, they were all the best jubilating because it's about Leska. Every one of them under the umbrella of Leska. They are with us in prayer, and tomorrow you'll see again, Tuesday, you'll see new breed of players playing in the FA Cup.
Thank you very much, coach.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Yeah. Oh.
I swear to God, all the best best movie, the prime movie that you can think about. Our culture, only Light TV, the drama, comedy drama. You want to see in your mouth, I think funny, tune into Light TV, you will see me clear, color, color, visa, be back, back, out to out. I tell you, you see Rusty, so you take by the money, you sit in your living room. Make sure you tune into Light TV. Because I'm going to go back, because of Light TV. Light TV is the best station, they entertain me every day. So, wherever you are, whether you're Liberian, you're Sierra Leone, you're Guinean, I'm in your mouth. Saying that England refused to come to Liberia now a year now because of Light TV, tune into Light TV. Anyway, you see me more mad, my mother has to in there. Oh yeah, he
Television viewers, welcome back to another episode of today's edition, What's the Latest? What's the Latest is our program brought to you by Light TV, and I'm your presenter, Matilda Jordan Frank Williams. Just in case you don't know what